Welcome to Saturday Story Circle, always on the Mutual Audio Network.
The following audio drama is rated G for general audience.
It's time once again for America's favorite show, The Radio Adventures of Dr. Floyd, brought to you by DrFloyd.com.
As you recall, we are reviewing the events that led up to Dr. Steve shooting Dr. Floyd with some sort of weapon that caused him to disappear. In our last episode, we witnessed the treacherous treachery of Dr. Steve in action when he went back to Boston in 1854 and convinced the Bostonians to put the kibosh on the opening of the first public library. We begin this episode in present-day Saddle River City, where we find our heroes returning the books they checked out shortly after the close of Season 7.
Hey, Dr. Floyd, the tales of your adventures in the literary world inspired me to read more classic literature.
Me too.
Well, then I guess some good came out of all that jumping from book to book. What book did you read, Chips?
Moby Dick. Oh, it was pretty tough to get through in some parts, but I'm glad I read it.
That's good. And how about you, Dr. Grant? What literary classic did you read?
One of the timeless novels by that renowned author, Pilkey.
Pilkey? I don't remember him. What classic book did he write?
The Adventures of Captain Underpants.
Captain Underpants? I don't know if I'd consider that a classic, but at least you're reading. Anyway, let's return our books. Good afternoon, Agnes.
Oh, good afternoon. Can I interest you in our new Double Frost Yukon Calf Decaf?
What in blazes are you talking about, Agnes? We're here to return our books.
Return your books?
Yes, here's my copy of Little Women, here's Chip's copy of Moby Dick, and Dr. Grant's copy of The Adventures of Captain Underpants.
Well, you can't return those books here. The only books we sell here are little picture books with inspirational yoga top phrases on each page.
Something is very wrong here.
I'll say. Agnes, is this or is this not the Saddle River Public Library?
Oh, no. This is one of many in the chain of fine Super Soggy Sugarbuck stores.
Super Soggy Sugarbucks?
Yes, sir. Serving America's finest coffee and coffee derivative drinks in an adult contemporary music-filled atmosphere.
Agnes, where's the Saddle River Library?
What's a library?
What's a library? Oh, no!
Something is definitely very wrong here. Chips, scan the time and space stream and see if you can figure out what's going on.
Righto, Dr. Floyd! Dr. Floyd, I'm picking up some time ripples. Apparently, I was so engrossed in the ending of Moby Dick, I failed to realize that Dr. Steve had made a time jump.
Oh, he's got to be behind all this. Remember when he vowed to make sure libraries don't exist at the end of Season 7?
Where is he, Chips?
According to my scan, he's just left Boston in 1854.
There's no time to lose. We gotta fix history and make sure libraries exist.
But what about returning our library books? They'll be late.
Where would we return them, Dr. Grant? Libraries don't exist.
But if libraries don't exist, how did we check them out in the first place?
Stop asking reasonably intelligent questions about our paper-thin plot, Dr. Grant. We've got to go stop Dr. Steve!
One time jump later, our heroes are in Boston in the year 1854. They stand watching the citizens of Boston boarding up the windows of the Boston Public Library.
Excuse me, ma'am. Why are they closing down the nation's first public library?
Because we, as a town, decided that we don't want a public library corrupting our youth.
Corrupting your youth? Idea.
Well, this slick-talking gentleman with a unibrow and a black cape came into town and did an elaborate pattern musical number and convinced us that libraries were nothing but trouble with a capital T.
But he was wrong. Public libraries are one of the greatest resources a community can have.
That may well be, but you're not going to be able to convince me, or the rest of the citizens of Boston, for that matter, without an elaborate musical number of your own.
Oh, dear.
What are we gonna do?
If they want an elaborate musical number, then that's what we'll give them. Chips, do you have your pocket piano handy?
Never time trouble with anything.
Great, now give me something in the key of B, and Dr. Grant, you follow suit.
Yes, sir.
Citizens of Boston, gather around. I've got something to tell you. That's right, come on in here. Now, I know you've been told that a library is a bad thing, but I'm here to prove you otherwise. Why, a library is a wonderful place, a magical place, a place that can give you so many amazing things.
Yeah, like what?
Well, hit it, Chips. The library where all the knowledge you can name is there for you. All you need to do is let it leap inside your brain.
The library, everyone.
every night, my good friends and I sit so quiet and look through all the books. You couldn't read them all if you tried. They're checking out books is the plan, and we think that the plan's really grand. And when we say yo, I-yip-I-O-I-yay, we're only saying we really love the library. The library's okay.
Everybody sing.
The library, where all the knowledge you can name is there for you. All you need to do is let it leap inside your brain. The library, every night, my good friends and I sit so quiet and look through all the books. You couldn't read them all if you tried. They're checking out books is the plan, and we think that the plan's really grand. And when we say yo, I-yip-I-O-I-yay, we're only saying we really love the library. The library's okay.
Yo!
Wow, were you ever right? The library's a great place.
I told you.
Come on, everybody. Let's go reopen the library.
Great work, Dr. Floyd. I had no idea you were such a showman.
6 seasons of summer stock in college. Of course, that was a long time ago.
Huh, a very long time ago.
Dr. Grant.
Well, I suppose with history back on the right track, we should return to the present and return our library books.
Yeah. But why not try to pick out something with a little more depth this time, Dr. Grant?
Oh, don't worry, Dr. Floyd. I already have a classic book in mind. Want to know what it is?
I'm afraid to ask.
It's a tale of animal bravery in the face of adversity.
Mrs. Frisbee and the Rats of Nim?
No, Walter the Farting Dog.
Oh, good grief. Let's go.
And with that, our heroes take off for the present. Where will their adventures take them next? Where will their reading adventures take them next? And how does Dr. Steve feel now that Dr. Floyd's beaten him at his own musical number game?
Losing so defeating fills me with such anger.
Hold it, Dr. Steve. We don't have enough money to pay for royalties for another song.
Oh, curses.
Tune in next time to the radio adventures of Dr. Floyd.
Episode number 803 of the radio adventures of Dr. Floyd starred Maura Quirk as Chips. www.mauraquirk.com. Allison Mork as Agnes the Barista and various townsfolk. And Donna Kimball as Mrs. Dunlop. Music for this episode by Jody Whitesides, www.jodywhitesides.com. The song Oklahoma is from the musical Oklahoma by Rodgers and Hammerstein. New lyrics by Grant Pachoco. Get your parents' permission and give us a call on our voicemail line at area code 818-332-3053. This episode was recorded at Dr. Floyd Studios in beautiful downtown Burbank, California. Episode number 803 of the Radio Adventures of Dr. Floyd is copyright 2010, Grant Pachoco and Doug Price. All rights reserved.
Clear the airwaves! Clear the airwaves! It's time now for the Radio Adventures of Dr. Floyd Imagination Nation Ranger secret message. Remember, kids, only children with the official Radio Adventures of Dr. Floyd Imagination Ranger secret decoder ring can decode today's secret message. You can get your own ring right now over at www.drfloyd.com/store. Okay, kids, grab your secret decoder ring and a pencil and paper and prepare to set your imagination to fun. Here comes today's secret message. And here is the Radio Adventures of Dr. Floyd secret message for episode number 803, Fighting Choir with Choir. 4, 11, 17, 23, 7, 16, 18, 15, 3, 20, 5, 3, 1, 3, 20, 14, 8, 1, 12, 1, 7, 9, 9, 11, 15, 18, 20, 9, 3, 17. And that was a secret message to you from Dr. Floyd himself. You can decode today's secret message only with the Imagination Nation Ranger's secret decoder ring available to everyone at www.drfloyd.com/store. Get yours today and set your imagination to fun.
Hey, Fidget, you know what? I'm totally cool. Because I've just signed up for a Twitter account.
What?
Yes, it's at www.twitter.com/evilmastermind.
And what are you gonna do with that?
Well, I plan to send out totally inspirational and completely evil messages to all my followers.
Oh, brother.
Hey, look, if it worked for Richard Simmons, it'll work for me.
Don't just sit there. You're under strict orders to go to www.parary.com, hip.
This is Jack Ward, and from everyone here at the Mutual Audio Network, we wish you all safety and protection during the COVID-19 outbreak. Join us as we listen and imagine, and together we'll make it through this. Please be safe.